Coleshill by Fiona Sampson. Read by Fiona Sampson. A Spoken Ink production. Prelude. November makes blue smudges between trees, sfumato. Drifts down the lane, familiar as the neighbour I call fear. Again, this occlusion, this instability of light. Again, the unseen thumb printing the lens as I lift it, shining to my eye. Canto. I'm suspended. Below me is a dark pool. When I plunge a hand in, water breaks on my palm, a splash of black mercury. All of us, floating and stalking, are flat-footed insects, water boatmen, dimpling the dark. Little Virgils. Night after night the guides come, old enemies, old rivals, and A as he was 10 years ago. They pass close, speaking in their new night voices, and they see me, oh, they see me, laughing, shaking, crying. I'm as real to them as one of those on-screen heroines, huge, bright-skinned, her eyes filling with the world's tears. Sonnet 1. A Dream. These warm spring nights, it seems as if you float in formless dark. Your dreaming mind seems somehow close to limitless, and all the world at stake. Something in the room shifts and wakes you. Like lace dropping lightly on your face, a draught enters your dream and lifts it from its tracks. The incubus is back. He's on your chest, half absence, half beast grown fat on lack. He settles in to break you, break the dream. Orphic. The vixen was a silhouette. In milk, perhaps in whelp, she trod and trod. Her mistake was forming like shadow in the muscle. At night, each thing smells sweet and full of signals. The verge plants are coarsely drawn with ink. Propped akimbo, the soiled fox seems to mouth some vast affront, her head thrown back all jaw, a long bone made to resonate, a cleated bone made to string, then pluck, the way a wheel is strung from its rim. From the Adulterer's Songbook. Return at night. What remains is one clear note, the night odour of living air, almost descant, almost out of reach, like roses' fugitive aroma. That last note held. Sonnet 2. The Death Threat. The early dark thrums with wings. Shadows scud between headlights. A window at the road's end gleams like a gaze, too long, misplaced. He changes shape. The autumn nights permit this with their mint of smells, the ash and damp notes of a dream you remember, blurred as wings flurrying into a windscreen.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.